I'm Dr. Kondziolka, professor of neurosurgery and radiation oncology at New York University, NYU Langone Medical Center. Well, there's a lot changing in radiosurgery, specifically across all types of domains, benign tumors, malignant tumors, vascular malformations, functional. There's been hardware developments and software developments. I think we're seeing more hypofractionated or multi-session radiosurgery procedures, not just a single session case, but doing procedures over three, four, five sessions. We've expanded the use of radiosurgery for some larger volume disorders, particularly complex meningiomas or metastatic resection cavities that are bigger, where we will treat the patient over three, four, 5 days. So we're excited about this. There's still outcomes data that needs to be collected to check the response rates in comparison to standard single session radiosurgery as we know it, but we're excited about that. Obviously, some institutions are extremely experienced doing radiosurgery. They can make a dose plan very quickly. They're comfortable choosing that dose for this patient based upon their own experience. And yet a newer site may have a lot of difficulty. It may be labor-intensive to get a dose plan. They're a little nervous at utilizing that dose in a deep critical brain location. And so the ability to facilitate care and bring the early user up to the level of the more experienced user through standardizing planning and software, giving them tools that understand outcomes, I think this is really important. I think one of the key things is that this is an information technology driven field, and how we treat our patients is based upon published outcomes. And in radiosurgery, the outcomes are often delayed, as you know. So, of course, with malignant disease, we can look at survival, we can look at tumor responses over the short term, but for benign tumors, it can take many years, and or AVMs obliterating over time, to know how did we do 5 years later for hearing, for example, with a vestibular schwannoma patient that we took care of 5 years before. So it's through real sophisticated high fidelity data collection through registries that we can see how we are doing and share that information better and evolve our own care. So we're constantly evaluating our own outcomes through our prospective registry collection. So that's through software and information systems.